today. Let's start up everything. Still cannot hear me as always. Refresh. I've decided I wanted to do EL2 Sturmovik, but then I looked at the prior numbers and it was... Let's start up. Okay, kinda disheartening. This is my setup, as you can see. Now you can see also through my eyes, thanks to the magic of VR. And this is a wonderful OVR draw. Look how... What the heck is this? Return to your former self. Okay. It's been possessed. And now this goes to the left and scrolls like this. And we're gonna have in this way the very useful window from Facebook. And... But I want it on top, because I'm gonna be driving today. Top view! Yes, but the correct window, please. This one, perfect. Well, more or less, it's a bit off-center, I don't know why. Wait, maybe I have to reset my sitting position. No, it doesn't care. But then I guess we won't care either, because it doesn't make all the difference. In any case, I should be going to look at the road most of the time. And Dirt Rally 2.0, here it is. Ah, let's hope today I don't suck too much. I'll do my best. So, as you can see, through my own eyes, this is a Place It challenge. I'm speaking also to the new guys that could have come to the stream since I shared it elsewhere. We're running on a Place It chair. It is the one that folds, so you can put it away very easily. With the difference that I also attached to it a couple of... TV stands, basically, they're like TV stands, where I place my flight controllers, which is the ones I use the most, actually. Even though today, finally, we're also using the wheel. This one locks in place, basically. And the pedals, in fact, are from the series of Cytec that is used normally in flying games, but it works well also with driving. Only downside to this is when you go back to a normal car, an actual car like I did today, you're going to have a heavy foot. Because you're used to these that are very much harder. In fact, they're quite hard, because in theory they're both brakes. There is no accelerator. But by now I got used to them for the purpose of driving, and they work fairly well, in fact. So you no longer have to swap constantly from one to the other. Ah, there's grease today. Let's do grease. And with kit cars. Okay, I kinda like this category. It's the one from the newer... Yeah, but I haven't upgraded anything yet. In fact, well, okay, I guess, let's see how it goes. And as I was saying, well, the wheel is a G29, and also the cable is hung from the ceiling through what is essentially a couple of, you should be able to, here it is, retractable keychains, as you can see, very simple and very effective. This is also good for VR standing games. And the keyboard is here, on another monitor mount. My old monitor mount, in fact. I bought a new one, I thought, let's find a new use for the previous one. Also, the flight controllers are kept in place with C-clamps, basically, the one for woodworking. Oh, I wanted to pause. What happened? I clicked outside of the... Yeah, lost focus on the window. And these are also little mistakes that can happen. Let's do it, guys. I'm a bit better with this compared to Project Cars, but I'm still not an excellent driver by any means. Still, I enjoy it like crazy. It's one of the coolest things. No, I know what happened. It happened to me previously also. When you alt tab outside the window, which I didn't do actually, but having clicked outside, it becomes a bit grainy. Yeah, you can't solve it a bit doing that. But it will be fixed only after this race. Unfortunately, this is an online race, so I will have to do it nonetheless. Also, it worsens performance. What a stupid mistake. Ah, wait. I also got to put it in 120 Hz. Yeah, this is another useful thing you can do through the Index headset. I use to... Ah, but it did it again. Yeah, it's grainy. It's terribly grainy, in fact. Do I do the entire race like this? Well, let's do it. I mean, it wouldn't look good to restart already. It looks like it will ruin my record, because you cannot actually restart online races such as this. It's one of the daily events. So please have patience with the graininess of it. It will improve soon enough. After the race, I think. after the race is shown. Well, that's it basically. This is a great place heat, to tell you the truth. The way everything is kept in place is very new to me. I used to just clamp my wheel to the table and go with it. But also for the joystick, everything is much more convenient. Let me listen to the engine a bit more. And well, of course, if you have never tried it, this kind of driving games in VR are exceptional. One of the most immersive things you can do. By far. This game originally didn't have good performance in VR when it came out originally in the summer. Then by September-October they made a second version of it, and now it runs fairly well. Still has some strange glitches in it, like when you're racing in the night, it glitches like crazy, it's all shimmering. And also when it rains, it looks horrible because the raindrop effect is overdone. Then you're basically forced to use the hood view, otherwise you see almost nothing. But the times it work well, like when it's day and you race along the road like this, it looks amazing in VR. I wish I could show you it in full resolution. Now it will be come next race. Unfortunately, the mistake I did with my clicking outside of the window has caused the resolution to go down. I have no idea why it does it. It's typical with these games in VR. They make the initial thing, then they basically abandon it, and it goes how it goes. And well, I also use the throttle of the plane for the handbrake, and it works fairly well for that. In theory, I have the joystick on the right, should have been my shifter, but it only goes sequential, then I prefer to use the one. You cannot use it as a rear shifter. I prefer to use the one on the wheel. I tried to configure it as an actual shifter, especially for playing Truck Simulator. But there are no settings for it. Besides, without the clutch, it doesn't make sense. Originally, I always switched the pedals when I went to do driving from the flight ones to the driving ones. But it's so much more convenient to just open the chair and be ready to go. You see, this thing, when you're done, it's like a garden chair. You close it, you put it by the bed, and you forget about it. You can do whatever you want in the room, it's extremely convenient. Much more so, originally you had to bring down the wheel, position the pedals, and still they moved about. It was probably my best underrated purchase that I made following the VR system. Now I no longer play anything that is not either in VR, uses the simulation controllers, or possibly both. Normal gaming just doesn't do it for you anymore, once you get used to it. I always try to speak with great enthusiasm about these things, and the reason I started to stream is to make it more known. I hope VR to be the future. And by now it seems that people are starting to take notice of what it might be for gaming in general. Still, I think it will take some time. This is one of the newer trucks, the one that came out with the DLC. Actually, it was in the previous Dirt, no? They made this thing with the seasons, that you have to buy one after the other, and also they put in them old trucks, because why not, no? Even better. Then we buy them, so maybe I should be the last one to speak. It's just so damn good in VR. Never played a rally game this much in my entire life. I think it also kind of shows. But maybe Cigarelli back in the day on the Dreamcast, but that was fairly different. Ah, finally. I don't know if I should restart the game, considering the problem I have with the graininess. Probably it's better to be sure it loads in a second in any case. I seem to remember it's going to work after the next race, but let's just start it nonetheless. I think no one already... it's the weekly challenge, okay. Perfect, even better, so we can continue it after I restart the game, so I correct the little problem I have. is updating. Yeah. No more mistakes now. And hi Jonathan, thank you for approving my message. Grazie per aver approvato il mio messaggio. Possiamo anche comunicare in italiano, se vuoi. In realtà siamo connazionali. I'm undercover. I mean, I'm a secret Italian, actually. Always speaking English. Well, but because most Italians do speak English, no? And the inverse isn't very true often. So I thought I better improve my reach as much as possible. Since Facebook doesn't do the most excellent job of helping you in that regard. Okay, let's go on. I like Wiz, I haven't played it much yet. Must have just begun. There were only like 100 people in the rankings. Well, man, that's better. It will look better. It will seem like I'm one of the best ones, even though probably it's just because there aren't many. Cloudy. I didn't check the length of the stages, but they seem short enough. Maybe even so short that I should have gone with soft tires, but we will probably have the occasion. I like this livery, so yellow, makes me think of the summer. What the hell is happening? Why is it still grainy? Ah, continuous technical problems these days. Huh. And let's do it like before. But it will look worse than it does originally. Than it does usually. I don't know what happened. There is something strange. This is really unlucky. I'm trying to think. Never experienced it. It's a new bug. Well, maybe I shouldn't even restart the game then. No idea. I'm constantly having problems this day. This morning the internet. Then the phone rings while I'm doing crazy dog fights over the skies of the Ruhr, playing with friends. And I end up having to play alone. I've been unlucky with my stream too, these days. Woo! Ah well, I think I will have to play like this. Normally it runs better though. I'm thinking. This is a bug, because you can tell it's a bug. Because it's easily solved by going to the options and switching back the anti-aliasing, but normally does it only when you alt tab out of the game, and I didn't. So what the heck is this? Maybe if I put the game in full screen mode, it will be solved. It looks bad. Normally it looks better. Probably I should go play single player while I try to sort it out so I can restart the race. Honestly, I don't know what to do. It never happened to me. It's not that set related in my opinion. It must be the game itself. I wish the game still had the uphill specialty, and unfortunately they took it out. I think they wanted to make a DLC about it. Thank you, Amner, for approving my post, so it can be seen in another group. Ooh, be careful! No, I came so close to doing it, and then I did it, of course. What sort of tree was that? Okay, let's never speak about it again. But I'm distracted because the game looks bad. What the hell is happening in the technical department today? Into six left and six right of a bump. And six left Ma seriously, that tree look kinda strange. That like a bell, it was spear shaped. Now when you're speaking about plants in a rally game, usually it's not a good sign, but still. You see, that's the reason you best use an external shifter when you're doing rallying, because how the hell are you supposed to downshift during a turn like that? You'll never find the paddle. Well, maybe real drivers can find it. No, this is ridiculous. But it didn't overturn, okay. Okay, finish, so we can try to solve the problem again. So what might it be? What might it be indeed? I won't even stop, don't care, okay. I'm gonna kill you. Repsol. What's that, some kind of soft energy drink? graphics. No, but not from here, probably from the main menu. Exit 1 second. Excuse me, guys, I have some strange technical problem. I don't know. Never experienced it before. In fact, I did experience it before, but it was because I had alt-tabbed out of the game. Today I didn't. Well, the second time I didn't. So what might it be? I think I have to put it full screen. This is what I feel. Not that I can find a way to do it. Presumably alt-tab. Plus rebound. Yeah, like this. It's not the multi-sampling, it's something different. Let's not waste too much time on it. I mean, it's playable. So I won't waste too much time on it. Go on, it's 9 stages. Argolis. It doesn't do it while it loads, no? Because it wouldn't be too simple. You only can tell once you're finished, and you have to do the entire race like that. This is very important, guys. If you play in VR, do buy this application. I think it's solved. It tells you if the game is running badly. Because if the game is running badly in VR, you don't notice. You only get sick. You get dizziness from it. No, it's doing it again. And then let's change the anti-aliasing. Maybe if I put it to... Yeah, this improves it, but it's not like it is usual. Usually it's more high resolution, I have no idea. In the night it's less apparent. In any case, since I love to play like this. No, but now it's not too bad with the night. You see the shimmering I was speaking about? The rocks shimmer a lot during the night. That's just the way the game is made. Someone confirmed to me on stream, just the way it runs. Ah, by the way, guys, if you have comments or something to ask anything, this is a live stream, I can read you. I have the comments up there. Whatever you want to ask, no problem. I will probably crash and die when I try to read the message, but that's on me. That's the risk you incur into when you decide to live stream a rally game. It's so easy to post only good times when you're not doing it live, of course. Maybe for me it wouldn't be easy even then. Just your presence is enough to get me pumped for the race. In the darkness of the night. Outs I played this game, no problems. I get on with streaming it and it does something strange with the resolution. What the hell? I actually played this with Vorpex even before they released the actual VR version from it. Because you might be surprised, but it works fairly well, that application. Any game is playable in VR actually, you just have to feel a desire of it.
unseen one left long. Into six right of a crest, extra long.
Should have used the handbrake there. It's not always easy to prepare for the big turns. So today I take the car after a while. It's a tiny smart car, you know the smart, no? It's got actually a rather sensitive accelerator. I went and pushed with all my might as I do to steer the planes I normally fly, you know, with these big pedals of mine. And it skips ahead like crazy. I got scared for a second. Then I got used to it again. Used to drive much more. Lately doesn't happen that often to me. Actually, you can set the tension of these pedals, but only for their main movement, which is the one that signifies to push them or pull them ahead or forward. I mean, they go also in another movement, the one for the airplane, like this. This is what I mean. I better explain it by showing, since I can't find the words. I bet you got my meaning. Well, the shimmering rocks are also kind of helpful. They let you see very well the space of the road that you have available. Okay, never mind. So it's a bit late, but could have been worse. I like how he says bumps, 50 over bumps. Unseen to right long, okay. This is a difficult section. Hi Marco, thank you for liking my post. I appreciate a lot. It's my pleasure to show you guys the beauty of VR. The more people know, the better. I bet some of the regulars will show up later in the stream and help me with comments. Because, woo, what did I do? It's kinda hard to find matters of conversation while you're driving a car at breakneck speed in the depth of the night. I usually can't talk non-stop when I play the playing games because I comment on my strategy and the situation of the battle. Here on from time to time, I tend to shut up, also for listening to the copilot, that is also true. And six left, extra long, tightens of a jump, 70, five right, 50. For some reason, I don't think in real life that kind of rollover would have left me with much desire to keep racing through the night, as I said. But here, I suffer no damage, I'm like a Terminator, another wonder of VR.
Opens 80.
right of a crest, into six left, opens of a crest, into six right long, tightens, into five left, into six right, very long of a crest, slow 30, turn one left. Opens and tightens three long.
So I was reading earlier the news about the fact that they announced GTR 3, you know. Have you heard about it? The famous driving series of old. I used to love GTR 2. It was always installed in my PC, never uninstalled it for years. Only thing, I hope they support VR. They don't support VR in 2020, I'll never buy your game. But in fact, I almost never buy games by now, because they make so few in VR. So good thing we have some at least like this. I will keep the anti-aliasing the same. Let's see if it's it does the wrong thing again. I don't know what the problem is. I'm 20th. I'm 20th in the entire community in theory, but I don't think much of the community has already raced on this event. Otherwise, you usually end up much higher. Still, it didn't feel too slow. Come on. Apart from that big mistake, still nothing too bad. Ipsuna 2 Dazos. Ah, this is the stop, okay. Repair the car. And what is the situation here? We're going to meet... this is night, day, cloudy, 6, 5, 4 kilometers. Practically all gravel and gross gravel. Soft tires, this is 1/4 soft tires, not too long. Also, this is a pitch black, but this is better since I have that horrible resolution problem, so it will be less apparent. Let's see it go. Of course it does it again. Look at this. This is extremely stupid. I will try to remove the full screen at this point. I honestly don't know the origin of the problem, so that would be hard to solve. At least I know the workaround, because it happened to me previously. But it happened when I did something wrong. Now it does it nonetheless. Could it be maybe the resolution scaling of the headset itself? But in any case, the workaround kinda works. Of course, it's a workaround, but still it's grainy, normally it looks better. Like looking through Vaseline. Runs well, but there is something wrong, you can tell. What a shame, what a true shame. Maybe I could try to Google the problem after this race, just briefly. Okay, let's keep the gears down, because every time I go up, I lose power. Here, it's a slow section of track. I hope the guardrail holds. Yes, I think I'll go to the Steam forums and see what they say about this problem. I bet some people must be complaining about it. It's not like the game had a big update recently. Probably it was the new drivers from Nvidia. I always had that problem in the beginning. Then I stopped experiencing it. And now it's back. But it's not Steam VR, because if it was Steam VR it would do it also in the menu. And it does it only within the race, it must be the game. A fellow VR player is coming online. You can never know what they play on Steam, because actually the support apps for VR, like OVR Drop, the one that shows the desktop over there, or FPS VR, the diagnostic, actually take priority, so you never know what they're playing on Steam. It's the same for me, I have like 600 hours on the diagnostic and it never shows the name of the actual game I'm playing. It's a bit mysterious. This certainly doesn't help the promotion of VR games. Not like anyone cares in the Steam space, in any case. Oh, the rock! Okay. You hit the rock, you're bound to break the tire. If you break the tire, you lose 30 seconds. Unless you go with the broken tire, but it's practically impossible. Well, if you're so close to the finish, man. Good, 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 good. Here we are. Woo! Wee! I think I killed a man. It tends to happen from time to time. So let me look at the Steam forums just a sec. I want to understand what the heck is the problem. I bet someone is talking about it. And honestly, what happened when I replaced? Scambi, eventi. How to use. Okay, no one is speaking about it. Then I guess we'll have to play like this. There was a patch the 20th of January, and then it's this. It's the new patch. They don't seem to have changed anything in regards to performance, so it's anyone's guess. Really, really, shouldn't do like this. 15th? That's not bad. 15th. That's an Italian player, Lupo the Wolf. No, actually, it's got the German flag. But it sounds Italian, the name. Lupo means wolf in Italian, that's the point. And then what can I do? Let's try to reset the settings, no? I put them on medium. Then we lower again, maybe. Vehicle, no. Objects, you can lower it. We don't care much for this stuff, only replay mode. No. Replay. Polvere sulle bottiglie, no. So maybe resetting the quality. Change also this. Yes, then you put it back. And try to restart, I don't know. Let's see how it goes. I'm feeling lucky. Like you used to tell Google, no? I'm feeling lucky. Okay. We're starting. Pomona Ecriki. I think it's red Ecriki. Should be in theory. Hard to tell without the actual Greek alphabet. It looks good until it starts. When it starts to look bad. Look at that. Vaseline. This is crazy. Okay, you put in CMAA. And it's okay. They did something with the patch. They patched it yesterday. I bet it's their fault. I changed nothing. They don't care about VR. There is a good probability that like 90% of the community has this bug. It will be sorted in like a month, probably. That's the way it is. What the hell? I love playing this game. I hate this. The workaround helps, mind you. It helps. You change the... what's his name? The anti-aliasing, it starts to look better, but it doesn't look like it should. It looks worse than the usual. Maybe I could reset the super sampling of the device. You know what? I can even try to do it now. That's not dependent on the game. Yeah, this one. Just change it a bit. Very little. Is it also the rendering? No, that's wrong. Motion smoothing deactivated. No, like this, okay. Nothing changes, but we will know for sure once I start another race. The problem presents itself at the beginning of the race. Every patch, they do something wrong, I swear. What the hell, I love this game, why do you have to do this? At least my provider isn't dropping the line yet, but I best not speak too loud. And my phone isn't ringing. I had this recurrent problem in the last days where my insurance company kept calling me to tell me to renew the insurance. Pay up constantly, 10 times, 15 times. I told them I will pay by the end of the month when the insurance runs out. But actually, I ended up paying this morning, so they don't interrupt my stream anymore. Always at the same time of day, while streaming, of course. Hey, that arrow was wrong, it pointed to the right, didn't it? Go, there's a guardrail there. No. Okay. Came close. But I didn't go off the track. Ciao Marco, sì, il freno a mano è un throttle. Serve anche per far accelerare il P51 Mustang nei cieli della seconda guerra mondiale. È un freno a mano multiuso. Ma anche i pedali sono un po' strani se ci fai caso. E comunque qui c'è il cambio volendo. Non lo uso mai perché è un po' da fessi, avendolo anche sul volante. Ok. A bit crazy, isn't it? And also the pedals do like this, just in case you feel the need to do it. You can fiddle with the pedals if you feel like it. Because, you know, when you're on the plane, actually, you turn like this. This makes you turn. And you press the pedal only when you want to brake. They're both brakes, basically. And in fact, they're pretty hard to press. No, lo stavo dicendo anche prima, sono duri da spingere. Infatti, risali su una macchina vera, quando acceleri fai salti in avanti. Questi sono molto più duri dei pedali veri. Grazie per aver commentato comunque. Ok. È un po'. It's a bit funny, isn't it? No, but it works. Stavo dicendo prima, perché alla fine comunque c'è tutto pronto così, che vuoi fare l'aereo, vuoi fare la macchina, è tutto pronto. Peccato che hanno fatto qualche casino con l'aggiornamento di Dirt. Io non so se si vede dalla vostra parte, ma quando lo faccio partire è tutto sfocato, sembra che guardi attraverso, non lo so, la vasellina. Infatti stavo toccando i settaggi nella speranza di risolverlo. L'unica cosa che riesco a fare, fai così si vede bene, però poi riparti e si rivede male. Non so che cosa sia successo. Ieri hanno aggiornato il gioco. Devono aver rotto qualcosa a livello di VR. Purtroppo. Vorrei tanto saperlo. Tanto come al solito non gliene frega un cavolo della realtà virtuale. Prima che lo sistemano ci vorranno mesi. What the hell, guys? Really? You break my favorite driving game of the moment. No, I want to get off Whistler Bone Wild Ride. But I didn't get off of it. Yeah. On the edge, living on the edge. Yeah, like the song used to say. I wish I could use music during my stream. Apparently, music is forbidden to streamers. Don't you ever try to stream with music because they will instantly mute your stream. Well, someone will. I don't know who. Who does it? I bet there is a little man that has only that job in his curriculum. I have to mute the streams that try to use music. I mean, in the end, you're ruining everyone's fun with your copyrights. They seem to exist for that singular purpose, to ruin everyone's I also, I no longer play the track simulation games, because to play the simulation games without the music, it's boring as hell. It was the coolest thing to stream the track simulation with the music. It could be sort of a DJ, but that's also forbidden. And you get no notice of it, of course, no? So you keep talking and talking, maybe for an hour and a half, and actually no one is listening to you. The time that it happened to me, I felt so stupid, but actually I'm not the stupid one. It's the law that is stupid. But I jest, of course. I understand the reasoning behind such measures. Not say better, there are people that take advantage of workarounds to such system. There always are. Strange how having the night version of the chat window up there, when you guys use emojis, I see also the colors of the emoji are inverted and they become kinda hard to understand. Like the laughing face emoji actually looks like a brownish blob. I should have a friend post some so we can try to test the problem. Don't break the car now that the track is finished. Let's do at least one stop correctly. I stop in front of the race judge, whatever he is. Okay, at least once. I will not run him over all the time. Yeah, it's a laughing face emoji. Looks like the angry face of a samurai. Well, I mean, there's not many people trying this race, but still, I'm classified pretty well. And I won't try to fix the problem anymore. There is nothing I can do. At least I know the workaround for it. Let's just keep playing, I guess. I gave up. Habeas coilada. Strange word. Sounds almost Latin instead of Greek. Habeas. Argolis is what we used to call here in Italy. We called it the argolide. Ciao Marco. Ah, sei sempre tu, ok. Beh, domattina, sì. Ma sai che io lo farei sempre. Io farei solo War Thunder. Il problema è che dopo un po' l'algoritmo di Facebook ti penalizza. Praticamente c'è una dinamica che si chiama... Aspetta, viene da dire il reach in inglese. Invece in italiano lo chiama... Beh, non mi ricordo come lo chiama. Ma il concetto è che se tu continui a postare sempre sugli stessi gruppi, sempre meno gente vede il tuo post. E quindi devi variare per forza. È l'unico modo di avere una visibilità decente. Let's put it four times, I guess. Why not? Quindi, domattina. Solita ora. 99%. No, per cui l'ho visto. Allora, ieri ho fatto tutte e due le volte War Thunder a retto. Stamattina, la terza volta... La reach è una cosa che ti fa vedere Facebook nel back-end. Era calata della metà della metà. Anzi, voi siete stati molto bravi e siete venuti a vedermi lo stesso. Ma in pratica, invece che 1000 persone, c'erano 300. C'è niente da fare. È Facebook che decide quanto ti vedono o non ti vedono. E parlando con altri streamer, insomma, stiamo cercando di capire perché. È fatto, per me non ha senso. Cioè, tu posti qualcosa al fine di essere indicizzato su Google, tutto funziona con una logica. Tu più posti su un determinato argomento, più acquisisci visibilità. E questo è corretto. Su Facebook è il contrario. Più tu posti, meno è visibile. Per cui devi necessariamente fare più di un gioco se vuoi essere uno streamer quotidiano. Altrimenti ok, lo fai una volta ogni tanto e fai quello che ti pare. Ma se lo fai tutti i giorni, per forza. Altrimenti non ti vedono più dopo un po'. I misteri di internet, guarda. Misteri di Zuckerberg, anche. No, guys, I was speaking with the Italian friend about... but I already spoke about it on this stream, I bet you've heard it by now. The problem that I have with the reach of the posts, no? Meaning how many people they reach. It's basically you get a penalty on Facebook if you keep posting streams of the same game again and again. Doesn't make sense, it's just the way it is. Just the way it is. So you have to play a variety of games. But it's not too bad, I mean, I enjoy them all. I enjoy also driving from time to time. I was thinking to go with Sturmovik today, but then I saw the state of the servers. There's only Russian people online, as usual. Sturmovik is the other big flying game. And at this time of day, you have a server that is mostly populated. It's named... what's his name? Wings of Liberty, I think. But the problem is that they're all Russians speaking Russian, so you will play in any case mostly solo. They don't speak English at all. In the morning you find some Americans and you can play it, but in the afternoon it's useless. Hi Mac, thank you for liking my post. I always appreciate in a particular way when the post is approved for specific groups. It means I'm not driving so bad, after all. So thank you indeed. No, the rock! What did I do? Well, realistically I'd be dead, I guess. So the game has been plenty gentle with me. Doesn't seem to drive as well as before, I probably broke something. Absolutely not visual on that rock in advance. Yeah, it turns a bit strange. As long as you don't break the tire. Ah, also I think I'm down a headlight. I have few headlights, and I can still see. At least, for as long as you have one, there's one life left, no? It's like the three lives of Sonic. When he's out of lights, he's out of lights, then he's dead. One light is enough, just like one ring is enough for Sonic. You gotta go fast, also in life. Five left? Don't get so nervous, dude. In fact, I played much more driving games before starting to stream. Now I'm a bit self-conscious when I attempt to do it, because I keep seeing people that drive so amazingly well compared to me. I tended to think I was an average player of this game. Now I think I'm below average, so it makes me a bit self-conscious to stream it. But the entire point of the stream is to show how cool virtual reality is. You don't have to be good for showing it. So usually I tend to always say this. For as long as you're having fun, it's worth it. It's worth it also to show how much fun you're having. It's all to bring more people in the VR space. This is my purpose at this time in life. Let's go ahead. This is called the Argolide in Italian. Argolis. I don't know exactly which place in Greece it is. Catodo Leontio. Here it is. I have it. It's my throttle. I use it as an handbrake. I haven't used it in the last race. It works fairly well, actually. It's surprising. You put it ahead, you go. You bring it backwards, it acts as the handbrake. I'm gonna show you the next... what's his name? Hairpin. You will see it. Let me do the thing again. Because of the new bug. That I hate with a passion. I show you my handbrake. Oh no, it works fairly well. Okay, like this, basically. And you are there. You best be careful, because if you slam it ahead and backward, you risk breaking it. It's of course much more fragile than an actual handbrake. But it's a nice second use for the throttle. Then for time to time you check it, because you're afraid it didn't go all the way forward. But actually it did. Here's the handbrake, can you see? We were just speaking about him. And now we have so many hairpins. Now I wanted to try to go faster in the hairpins. And of course I'm not good enough to do it. But still, it didn't go too bad. No. Okay. I saw that in its face. I said this is the end of me. But luckily, it didn't happen. The grim visage of the Great Reaper. What's his name? The Great Reaper. Shinigami. I speak so many languages. You know, you could set the hardware for the flight even on dirt. No, it's very convenient, in fact. It is. It's 10 times better to have everything ready at all times. Because in the end, no? Well, I used to play sims from time to time, but when you had to set up the room to play the simulator, you had to bring down the joystick, position the wheels, move the chair, maybe for a time even, since I have a swivel office chair with the wheels, I had to tie the chair, otherwise when I pushed the pedals it went backward. Then you no longer play these games, because there's such a hassle to set up for. Whereas if you have a single chair that you can pull out, and with the chair you're ready to play anything, you will do it. I never thought before how much that would have made a difference. And that was also another thing that I discovered thanks to VR. Too bad you cannot set the... Oh, why am I not using the handbrake now? Too bad you cannot set the joystick to act as a proper shifter. Because actually, yeah, they sell a shifter for the G29. But if I put my shifter to my right, I no longer have space for the joystick, and then I'm back to square one. Again, I have to switch and move around stuff. And that's not what I want. I want to open the chair and be ready for play. Anything. And as I said, I no longer play anything else, so it seems to have worked pretty well. This is my way of gaming. It has become the norm to me now. Nothing without VR compares to this. I see people speaking about all the new games that are coming out. I no longer care. For me, I'm no longer a gamer, probably. I'm a VR gamer, and that's something different. You don't play games with the same joy that you do before. Once you start to play VR, they're just no longer enough for you. If only more people could experience it, the famous revolution would arrive in like 2 months. This is my idea. Certainly takes some time to get used to the dizziness, the nausea, but if you can overcome that, your position is very comfortable. Yeah, no, it's not easy. Well, it depends on how you're driving. I'm doing kind of a hard drive. Your position is very comfortable for what I'm under. Yeah, that's the idea. It's it does two things. You know what is even worse than driving and speeding? Reading the messages and trying to drive. No, but don't stop, man. It's worth it, in my opinion. The main purpose of the stream is communication. It's to communicate the beauty of VR. So, it's more what happens there is more important than the game to me. No, I got your idea. Your location is very comfortable. No, I got what you mean. Yeah, that the seat is comfortable. It indeed is. So, Mac, do you also play War Thunder? Because if you do play War Thunder, we could play together. I'm always looking for new wingman. The more the merrier, as I said more than once on stream. When we have the full squad with Nyx and the others, we're 4 or 5 people, that's some of the best times I had in that game. Alone it's different, no? We were speaking about it with Nyx yesterday. When you're playing alone in War Thunder, you play only for the score. And so in the end, you're less thinking of the situation as if it were real. When you're with other people that you know, you tend to cover each one other. It's a lot of fun. That's also another game that is very underrated, especially the simulation mode of it. The other day I was playing in Sturmoik, no? And the players of Sturmoik tend to be a bit elitist. They only like their game because it's more realistic and harder. And actually one of them told to me, the other day I tried War Thunder, everyone spoke so badly about it, but it's not true that it isn't realistic. In fact, it's much more realistic than people think. Maybe even better than Sturmoik. And guys, I think it's true, for some planes at least. The handling of the plane is more realistic in War Thunder. The Mustang, most of all. It's not only harder, it feels better. I've not completed the hardware for War Thunder. Sometimes I play it, but only in the realistic battle. Not sim. Ah, meaning you need a joystick, probably. You know Nyx plays only with mouse and keyboard in simulation mode. I don't know how he does it, but if you watch his stream, in fact he does it. And he does it pretty well. Look what I'm doing now. I went to the fields, but I'm back to the road, so it's not too bad. Oh dear, yeah, this way. Yes, he plays with mouse and keyboard. What do you mean you didn't complete the hardware? So you are part of the hardware. Maybe you have the joystick but not the throttle, or maybe you're missing the pedals. The pedals are important, you know. I played for the longest time without pedals. And when I started to play flying games with pedals, I discovered a whole new world that's completely different. For World War II planes, at least, and even more for helicopters. Yeah, because it's true that you can map the axis to the twisting of the joystick, but it's just not the same. It's three times more immersive and at least four times more efficient. It gives you more precision. When you're shooting with a machine gun or a cannon and you're behind the enemy plane, it's very important. The yaw axis means everything. I need the joystick, the pedals and the gyro mouse. What is the gyro mouse? For the turret control, I bet. The gyro mouse. For the joystick you could get this one. This is the T1600. It's a very good joystick from Thrustmaster, not expensive at all. Probably the best I ever had. In my opinion it is. It's also very accurate. It was quite a surprise. They also sell pedals for it. I got the pedals from another producer. These are Sidek pedals, but they make the pedals for this. The throttle maybe could be better, I don't know, the hats aren't the best. It's got enough button. It has this paddle here, this paddle thing. Wait, I'll show you from the camera. There it is. Well, not that you can see, man. This part here, and unfortunately has lost a lot of precision for me. I don't know why, it skips around. I no longer use it in any case. It's supposed to be a pedal substitute, so it's not like I use it that much. I think it's got dark. Oh, not that dark. Because usually when you can see little with the camera, it means it's dark. Why it's not that dark yet? What do you mean the gyro mouse? I was thinking, you know, the last thing I could add to my setup is a trackball like here or here for controlling the rear turret on the gunships of War Thunder. It's been a big temptation. I normally aim the turret with the trackpad here, but it's just not the same thing. And also, you have to switch hand. Because otherwise you can't control the plane again with the bug of the anti-aliasing. Starting to hate this thing. As VR, because I am a PS4... Ah, I see. Usually, and the sorry VR is not compatible with VT. Gyro mouse attacks in a hat and uses... Ah, it's like... You mean the track ER, basically. I never heard it called like this. I am a PS4, the Sony PS4. So yeah, the one for controlling the sight, basically. That's very important, yeah, you need to be able to look around. I think players that use it well are even more efficient than VR players, because they can zoom, unlike us. And for some reason you cannot zoom in VR in War Thunder. It really has your ability of identifying enemy planes. I think it's a worth buy, but it's also quite expensive. Am I wrong? I think that thing costs quite a bit. Ah, because you're gonna play the game itself on PS4. Okay, now I understand the entire idea. Well, it's certainly a sound plan. Yeah, of course, the PS4 cannot power the VR of that game. It's too expensive in terms of resources. Maybe with the PS5 we're gonna see something nice in terms of VR. They seem to believe in the technology. Probably this is a technology that is going to explode once it's the standard in console space. I think also that it was hurt a lot by the motion controllers that were the fancy of some years ago, no? When the Kinect came out, everyone thought the motion controllers were the new best thing. Microsoft even tried to bundle it with the Xbox, and everyone who tried them basically thought the same, that they sucked, because yeah, in theory they had potential, but no one ever exploited that potential. Most of the games were very stupid and similar to the ones on the original Wii. And so when VR came out, everyone thought it's certainly a gimmick, like motion controllers used to be, which is completely untrue. It's quite the opposite, in fact. But unfortunately, I try to explain it to people now that I've been disappointed so much and repeatedly. I still hear it from time to time. VR is a game and it's destined to die. Yeah, man. Try to play once with VR, then we speak again. Everyone thinks to know what this is, and so few actually have tried it. Ooh, this came as a surprise. Then you have things like this, you see. They upgrade the game and they break the anti-aliasing in it. In VR. They're gonna fix it, yeah, in 2 months maybe. Probably this is the last time I play Dirt Rally in the next 2 months. Because now it looks horrible with this anti-aliasing bug in place. It also worsens performance, by the way. See no notice of it on the phones, because this is another thing. You have a problem in VR, it will be difficult to solve it. The user base is just too low. Summer, I will definitely switch to PC. 2 years ago I had assembled... Wait, I'll put it into pause because it's wrong. A game in PC, I then sold it because I had no time and I only played games like Uncharted 4 and Dragon Age. I'm back on simulators and indeed man, I agree. These games are good, but in the end, if you like something where you're constantly interacting with the game, where you actually make a difference within the context of the game, simulators are a whole other story. So you're getting a good PC, huh? That's great news, man. I bet it will transform your experience of gaming. It certainly did for me. So get also a VR system, no? I bet you will eventually. If you're interested in VR and simulators, you just cannot disregard the fact. Maybe you already have in mind one system in particular. There are several that are good now. And also some that are to avoid, I've heard. And I can tell you which are to avoid if you're interested. Well, I will tell you in any case, because I enjoy to speak about the thing. I am so glad of speaking about VR all the time. Basically, it's one. Don't buy the Vive Cosmos. I've heard so many bad things about it. Anything else is more or less good. Also, I'm not so sure personally about the Reverb, no? The one from, what is it, from... not remember. HP Reverb, I think. The one that is very high resolution, because it's... in the end, it's based on the Windows Mixed Media platform, and in my experience wasn't very good. I tried some of the first Windows Mixed Visors and they were very, very bad, in my opinion. Even compared to the first generation of the Oculus. Which, unlike this, still stands very well to the test of time. I think I could go back to the Oculus and play gladly, without problems, even though this is much better. But the Oculus did several things right. Several. The lens are very good. And also the hand controllers are excellent. For 100 VR is necessary in sim battles. On Dirt I can also use the triple monitor, but for 100 I need a VR. Well, many people play without it, and they're in fact quite good. I don't know, man. Certainly it's more immersive, more fun, that I can vouch for. On it being necessary, especially if you have the track AR, it's more or less true. It depends on your game style, I bet. It does add something, yeah? But you have to consider that in VR, you have some disadvantages compared to the standard flat screen pilots. First of all, you cannot zoom, and that's just due to the developer's laziness, unfortunately. They're going to fix it eventually, but I don't know when. And then second, you will always have an inferior field of view. Because, as it is, VR systems just don't have the field of view of real life. Even this, that is higher than average, especially if you put the lens very close to your eyes, you can put them ahead and backward, it still won't be the same on 3 monitors in terms of field of view. So, for checking your seats, for instance, no? If you have an enemy behind you, it's not the simplest thing. I discovered that method, I've shown it on stream many times. It's been a big discovery of mine from the last week. And I can even demonstrate it in the car. Now when we get to the finish line, I will. Basically, it consists of centering your view wrong, intentionally, temporarily, and so you can look wherever you want. It's necessary. to play in a competitive manner, War Thunder Online, against strong people, you've got to do it. And it works. I'll show you, once we pass the finish line. Basically, now I have it ingrained into muscle memory, and I can do it whenever the need arises. I used to never check my six because it was so hard to do in VR. Even if you bring your head all the way to the side, you'll never be able to look backwards. It's just an inherent limit of the VR system, so today. Well, maybe except the one that is very wide, what's his name? The P-Max, but that has other defects from what I've heard. Hey, thank you for commenting, Race Track Coach. You like my post, so thank you for commenting. It's from the sim racing wheel and rigs. I described my rigging in the beginning. I'm not out of topic, by the way. You can watch the replay at the beginning. I spoke about my rig, and also I can answer any question if you guys are interested. And well, the stage never ends. Now that I want to describe the little trick of mine, but we will have the occasion, I bet. Guys, it just sucks for the game to be bugged today. No, don't do it, man. What happened? I got stuck near the finish line. I hate this. Hey, I have to... This is the stupidest thing. No, as I was saying, no? Now that I passed the finish line. The thing is this, you want to check your six in a flight game, you do it like this. You don't do it like this, because you'll never be able to look backwards. Never. You can do strange contortions, but not the way you need. You center the view here, and then turn, and you can check your six. Then you do like this, and you look the other way, but I can no longer do it because the race is over. But that's the idea. Yeah, Juan, you said it well. At 1 meter from the finish line, that was the most horrible thing ever. It's not easy to drive and talk, like the friend said in the comments. So, have pity on me, I know, I messed up. Ah, also I'm done. Drive and red, yeah, also, not just speak. Drive red and speak. And I was doing the Monty Challenge, look at this. Let's go ahead with the Monty Challenge. I was at the finish rally, I think. Yeah, this is good. Jarvenkila, Yamza, and Talk, and everything. Yeah, man, thank you. How's the lighting condition? I'm getting dark, I think. No, still visible. Maybe I could try to... No, but it makes no difference. I don't know, man. The game is bugged today because of a patch, I think. And as I said, the resolution looks bad. I try to switch the refresh. Let's see if it helps. Whenever you start, I don't know if it shows on your side, but in VR it looks horrible until you change your anti-aliasing for each race. It's like a bug, and basically then you can play, but it still doesn't look as good as usual. That's the problem here. I think it also hung up. No, okay, here it is. They updated the game yesterday, and they broke the VR. If I knew it, I would have played something that's like Project Cars. Yeah, you see. You see how it is? Vaseline, basically. So, put it back to... You change it, you can also put it back, makes no difference. And since it didn't help, I'll also go back to 120Hz. What else can I change here? Nothing that makes any difference. I can go automatic rendering resolution. I don't know, let's try. I generally don't use it, I prefer to maintain control, but since the game is working badly, I mean... Maybe it will help. Apparently it didn't. Look at this, we are completely in the yellow. But you never know with this game. Sometimes, even if you see it in the yellow... Ooh, this is a much more reactive car. It's one of the higher ones. In terms of performance. I didn't see the car, actually. I just started the race. I was eager to begin. And there are no telling signs here. Let me see what car I'm driving. This is kinda crazy. Let's just go. Actually, the stronger the car is in rallying, in general, the easier the game gets, because it keeps to the road so much better. Other type of driving games, it's the opposite. The faster you go, the harder it is. But even there too, has support for Sony VR. But it's just the power of the system that cannot do it. You need a lot of power to be able to stream. I'm really stressing my computer to also stream while playing VR. What did I mean? Well, I meant about playing VR, but also adding the streaming on top of it. You get it. And just PlayStation cannot handle it. So that's what I said before. Maybe with PlayStation 5 it will change. Also, probably they should improve their tracking system. It's a bit outdated. It's the one from the Move system of motion tracking, basically. Let's hope I don't crash like 2 meters from the finish line like previously demonstrated. So this is a game that scales very well in terms of dizziness, no? If you're new to VR, you can set the fixed horizon option. So basically it's the car that moves around you. It's hard to explain. Strangely, it doesn't look too bad. It looks horrible while streaming because it doesn't make sense for people that are watching. But when you're inside of it, it's just perfect to get yourself acquainted with VR. It's much less nauseating, despite all the movements of the car. Probably one of the less dizziness-inducing games in the driving VR space. Killer. Like to use kit cars on the dirt track. Well, they didn't seem too bad. I drove the kit car category. Oh man, you had to write the message at that time. No, don't worry, don't worry. Yeah, they're not bad. This is better, of course, but they're not bad, in my opinion. Maybe you mean the actual track, like the oval track inside of the stadium. Maybe we'll do it after this race, you know, just for a change. But they kinda suck at it, to tell you the truth. When you're racing against the AI in this game, it's very difficult. Maybe a bit too difficult for me. I never win, actually. I seldom do. It's not like I never win, I just seldom do. Not the best app, you know? Still, it feels kinda good. When you're going sideways, it's always a good feeling. Okay. So, shall we do the rally cross? Let's do it. With the other cars on the track. Want to see if I can manage today. It depends. It has its moments. Some days I can do it, some days I cannot. This has many more people ranked, but it's not bad. 400 is not bad, especially if you don't do the car setup. I seem to have gathered that setting up your car correctly in this game really lets you do horizon turns. Because sometimes as soon as you start on the first stretch of road, already you see people with much better times than you on the first segments. So I guess they set their car different, because it's either or they cheated, but I don't think it's likely, or they did the car setup. So rallycross, and you know, I'm almost at stage 4 with this. Case in point, I don't even have the setup upgrade because I never do it. And now I'm thinking I should go and seek a guide online, because my opinion in this game can really make a difference. Okay, now let's try the thing I'm even worse at it. Ah, especially with Kit, I'll have to try it. Or maybe I shouldn't. You gave me a good idea, I shall avoid it. Let's see how much I'm going to suck today, I'm really close. Use the Joker lab to your advantage. I imagine if it didn't have the bug from before. Let's see. Maybe it's only on the rally side of things. Well, I mean the special stage side. Come on, don't keep me. No, of course it's there. Decide to do nothing. I want to see if it improves by itself. I don't know how you see it. For me, it's terribly low resolution. And in fact, no, I cannot keep it like this. I cannot even see the road. Stupid, a stupid guy. Maybe lower also a bit the details. When you have the other cars, you better. This. Yeah, that's enough. No, but you need the MSA, otherwise it looks too bad. Ooh, this is on tarmac. Okay. Already they're going faster than me. I know this track, okay. Is this legal? I don't know, I undercut the... Well, if you see how they drive in real life within this specialty, it's not within... it's not outside of the scope of possibilities. It's actually a rather spectacular specialty to look at, to watch on TV. Excuse me, I cannot even speak. I have to concentrate. Where is the Joker lap, by the way? I said I know this track, but actually I don't know it well enough, because I don't know where... Ah, here, okay, to the right. Mental note that I will instantly forget. Also, the guy that took the Joker lap is already faster than us. And, well, he pushed me. You saw. Why must you do this? Had a bunch of bullies. Okay, now it's starting to look like Lupin the Third while he's escaping from Zenigata on two wheels. Why must I always be the weeb of the situation? Kinda comes natural to me. Already I quoted an anime in my video description. Then I quoted another. And of course they all pass me. No, not yet, not yet. I do my best here. It's just that they do better. Okay, Joker lap. He's pushing me again. Well, someone must not have taken the lap, I hope. Maybe I will be able to overtake him. What's this? Ah, it happened to me the other day as well. You know what? I have no idea why. I didn't see the mistake I made, but it reset my car's position. So I guess I'm already out of the race now. It's not going to... No, it will penalize me greatly, even in addition to the position I lost. Let's try to restart. Honestly, I don't get this track. I don't know where the problem is. I come out of the Joker lap every time it resets me and makes me back. I'll try to keep close to them. I want to see what they do. Maybe also use... Ah, every time you restart, the bug comes back. That's even better. Thank you, Codemasters. And yeah, let's put this view. You see better in this mode. Oh, didn't notice it. See, this is also strangely... immersive in VR, you wouldn't think... Ah, maybe I went straight there. Yeah, okay, now I get it. I went straight there. Because, well, who designed this track? It really looks like that is what you're supposed to do. At least to me. Who designed this track? Okay, change of surface. Naturally, he did it better. I'll go to... No, I won't go to the Jogger Lab then. He made sure of it. And this is more or less my usual experience with the Rallycross in this game. They're just too fast for me. I don't know if you guys have the same experience. I don't think I drive so horribly bad on these tracks. Maybe I'm not the best, but these guys, they made them a bit too strong for the average player, in my opinion. And not so violent, as you can see. No. We're not going to amount too much after this. But I will keep trying, I don't want to give up already. It's so enjoyable as a game mode and so needlessly impossible. Maybe some of the others haven't taken the Joker lap yet. Yeah, this could have been maybe a bit lower also. This is another mental note for the track design. Here you go left. Well, at least now I know where I have to go. This is starting to look ridiculous. One final attempt. Maybe I should go external view for this, since they bump me so much. Let's do an attempt with that. External view. Going to look interesting. I don't think I play much in external since I got the view. Ah yeah, the usual bug with the super sampling. If I really can manage, we go back to the special stages, huh? This is probably easier played like this. At least you know in advance when they're going to crash into you. Not so you can crash into them. If my teacher Zach SD in rallying sees me, he's going to scold me to play with the external view. No, they are, but I think they also do like that in real life, I think. I've been told that it's not completely unrealistic. Feels so damn strange to drive like this in VR, to tell you the truth, huh? No, I cannot manage it. I have to go at least like this. Okay, well, I'm dead last, but also I took my jogger. I don't know what they did. I hope they didn't. This is my usual experience with Rallycross, I'm just not competitive. I used to be in the beginning, then I was bumped up a class, because the game also does that. The better you are at it, the harder it becomes. And I'm no longer competitive. Did I take a wrong turn? No, it doesn't seem so. There are some tracks where you actually... Hey, thank you for commenting my post. Ah, it's the one from this morning. There are some tracks where you actually can compete. But when it's like this, I don't know. I just not fast enough, it seems. The more I try, the worse it gets. I mean, you want to make an hard driving game. That's good, but also include options for everyone. They're not getting farther, they're more or less at the same distance, it's just that I'm so much behind. I would do another after this, but probably on a different track. Here I'm just not competitive. Just the truth of it. Yeah, okay. Rip again, my car. Okay. This is even worse than I expected, to tell you the truth. Look how angry. It makes sense from his point of view. He says, who's controlling my own car now? Yeah, I'm dead last. No, this is useless. I want to do rallycross, but maybe on a different track. Like this, it's useless. I always leave it for last, because I know I will do an horrible job of it. Yeah, I've been eliminated in everything. This isn't a worthy championship, I can abandon it. Let's start anew. Maybe on a different category. As I said, I tend to go faster with the better cars, even in proportionally speaking. Seat Ford, Renault Sport. Well, they have the same spec, basically. Maybe one is partly upgraded. No. And then let's try it. I have 2 million credits, yeah. Upgrade it. I'm so rich, man. Lettonia, okay. This is a track I seem to remember I can do. I should be able to do it. Or is it the fast one with the band? Well, we'll see soon enough.
Use the Joker.
No, I know this track. This I should be able to do.
Okay, get a good start and let's get you a result today.
Let's go inside the car, also looks better. Nice ad from GoPro, thank you GoPro. And again we have to circumvent the bug.
Go.
You know, the other day I did this with such a powerful car, so it might be different. You see how, depending on the track, they're more or less strong. It's like they have some mistake in their AI programming. Because there are some tracks where, okay, it might be hard, but they're manageable. Some others, they're completely impossible to overtake. I don't know, guys, what's your experience with this game. You should tell me. I've never personally managed to beat them on certain tracks. Let's start with the jogger. No, actually the jogger was the other way. Well, okay. What a bastard. You said it well, Mac. They're very bastards. They're very bastards. How the fuck do I talk? They're actual bastards. Maybe it was half Italian, half English. It actually would make sense to say very bastards if very was Italian. It would mean the real bastards. Oh, jogger lap. Such an awesome mode of play, ruined by sheer difficulty on certain tracks. I don't know. In my opinion, it's a mistake. I wonder if it's intentional. But even if it is, it's still a mistake. Like this, it's playable. If every track played like this in terms of rivals, it would be challenging but fun. Like it was on that track, to me it's just impossible. And there are another couple that are the same. They never make mistakes. They never lose even a second on their turns. Well, a second would be too much to ask for, but you get my meaning. I restarted this championship of Rallycross so many damn times. Because I like it, but when you're starting to lose the third, fourth race, there is no meaning to go on. Best restart. Should have gone with the handbrake there. Well, now I'm a bit bastard here, huh? But also, it's not like they didn't ask for it. Okay, did I come first? I think it's possible. He looks happy, so it's all good. No, the nature of Rallycross, you know how it is. Do the same thing 8 other times. Ah no, a guy came before me. But I'm 9th overall, that's not bad. Let's go ahead. Let's go ahead for another couple of races, but to do all 9 in a row, after a while you get bored. It's just the nature of Rallycross. Oh wait, repair the car though, huh? Okay. Then there is one single track. I don't remember the name of it. The one where it rains almost always. I don't remember the name. Mostly tarmac. Where they drive slow. And actually that is boring in the other sense. You outrun them in like half a lap and you will never see them the entire race. In my opinion, they should iron out the bugs of this AI. And also maybe solve the bug, thank you, that you introduced just yesterday with the anti-aliasing. Oh, which way? Okay. They just have to do it. It's their nature. It's like an inverted first love law of the robotics from Asimov. You shall hurt human beings as often as possible. And the second one being, you shall never let human beings remain unarmed by your lack of intervention, but always intervene to actually harm them. So say we all. You see, I'm not only a weeb, sometimes I also quote Western authors, not only Japanese ones. I'm a weeb, but not just a weeb. Oh, okay. Maybe I should try to play the Rallycross mod in free play, no? What's his name? The other mod where you can set your own difficulty and lower the difficulty to the minimum on the other tracks where it's unplayable and see what happens. Because if I'm correct, it probably will remain hard. There is some bug at work there. Just too damn hard on these tracks. This should be the normal difficulty of Rallycross. It's just that it's a different one on certain tracks. Much harder. Close your... What are you doing, man? Close your door. Ooh, they're both here. What's he doing? Is he having problems with the engine? He's so damn slow, man. Get off the road, grandpa. Was a bit rude with him, but he has no feelings, of course, he's just a bot. might regret maybe this line of thought once we have the famous robot uprising that everyone seems to be expecting. Maybe now I'm joking a bit too much because it has worsened my drive considerably, even more so than the usual. But still, I'm first. You see what I'm speaking about? You're not even dying that well, and I'm first. So there must be something strange at work with these other trucks in Rallycross. It's not intentional, in my opinion. And that's it. Why is he angry? You came first. I won the race. He was happy when I didn't win the race. Now he's angry because I arrived first. In fact, I'm 14th based on time, so maybe it's just that my rivals were even worse, I gather. I could do another, but honestly, it's a bit boring to keep doing the same thing again and again. Let's go to a special track now. What's his name? Special stage, yeah. I mean the normal rally. To do this 8 times in a row. It's cool, but 8 times in a row is a bit much. Let's do a daily race. A daily race? Is this Finland with the kit car, like Max said earlier? Unfortunately, they could not write the name of the track on the image, so now I don't know if it's what I wanted to do. Daily challenge, oh, this is Greece again, I don't want to do Greece again. Weekly challenge, community event, no, too long, that's just on a track, but I guess then it's this. Kit car again, let's go again with the Peugeot. And power it up, I have a lot of money, no problems there. No, this is New Zealand, okay. New Zealand, I think I'm pretty good at it, if I well remember the stage. I don't know which stage it is actually, but the track in general. Hawke's Bay. Are there actually hooks in New Zealand? Let me try one thing, I want to see one thing. Here the bug hasn't arrived yet, no? You still don't have the grainy view. What happens if I do the workaround before the game starts? Is it going to look grainy or good? Just a little curiosity of mine. Because if it looks bad again, then it's 100% a bug on their side, not coming from SteamVR or anything else. One left Titans. Good luck. Nah, here it looks still good, and it looks bad once it goes full screen. And it looks bad. Yeah, I think. Yeah, it's granny. So it's on them. They totally broke the game in the last patch. I mean, you can work around with this, but it's not the usual resolution. It's still lower and more shimmering in a way. I love to rewatch the stream. I don't know how it looks on your side. Within the headset, it looks much worse than usual.
Open hairpin right.
into three left.
The level of detail on these tracks is very high. The number of the variety also of plants. I think they did a very thorough research in terms of vegetation in this game. If you look closely, you can see a lot of different trees and plants, all positioned in a fairly believable manner. It really adds a lot to the game. And not many rally games before this had that kind of care put into the natural aspect of it. Depending, you don't see many animals. There's only a track where animals cross the road, and it really has no effect on gameplay. They always are too far to create problems. Just an aesthetic team. I think it was Germany, am I wrong? The one with all the little rocks by the road. Terribly sadistic way to design a race. With all these little rocks, as soon as you touch one, the tire goes bust. I haven't raced on that stage for a while now. Doesn't seem to come up in the daily challenges.
Right of a crest. Into five left. 30. Four left long Titans.
Into boom, six right. Boom. Yeah, we six don't left. Care.
Into two right Titans. Into two left Titans.
Ah, but this category of cars, the kit cars are called in the new DLC, they're not bad. They seem to have good drivability characteristics, all things considered, of course. They don't cost as much as the higher ranking vehicles, but they're still good. It's a nice in-between solution, so to say. Case in point, you see that thing? These are, they look like cattails, I think. They really researched it. I guess there are specific variety that is in New Zealand, and maybe I shouldn't look at the vegetation so much. Yeah, this. No, they're not cattails, but it's a very specific flowering formation. How long is this thing? It never ends. Right.
Opens into two left. Into one right long. Opens into four left. Very long. Tightens. Opens. Don't cut.
I remember reading angrily all the forum posts of this game when originally they had the VR support and it had so many damn problems. And finding absolutely no one complaining about the same things as me. It had the strangest bug where moving your head didn't give you one-to-one response in VR. It actually made you very dizzy, and yet I kept playing it nonetheless because I loved it so much. And no one spoke about it. The VR user base is just that small. And now I think with the new bug it will be the same. No one will tell them. Or the ones that will tell them will be unheard, and before they fix it, a month will pass. Probably this is the last time I play this game on stream for a while. I want to do driving, I'll go to Project Cars or Asset, where I suck even more. But maybe it's hard to explain, I don't know. I presume it looks good on your side, but in the VR it's grainy, much more than the usual. The way you can fix it by moving the option back and forth really lets you understand it's a bug.
Into caution, five right long, tightens one. left of a crest. Opens, keep right of a 60. Three left. Into four right. Four left, very long. 80. Two right tightens. Opens. Into three left long. Into four right. Opens of a crest. Into one right tightens. Opens. Into three left. Into five right. Into don't cut four left. Very long. Opens.
Endless stage. Basically the stage never ends. What is this? 25, 30 kilometers. I think his voice tone is raising. That means we must be almost at the end. Okay. If you break the fence there, you end up stuck. 100%. That's the end of the stage usually. But luckily it didn't break. Don't use some handbrake, at least on such an airplane, you're really wasting it. Felt fast, maybe one of the best of the day. Let's see how it went. Well, it's from yesterday, so many have already ranked. Depending on how many there are, 353 could be good or bad. Certainly not excellent, but still, it will let me earn. Come the end of the event. So also this is, by the way, the end of the stream, so thank you for having watched it to the end. If you are from the group where the topic is the rig or the setup, you can watch the replay of the video. At the beginning I described it. It's a fairly interesting setup that I also enjoy a lot, and also I can see now that it's got pretty dark, I bet, but I'm still visible. Good. And so, if you know me, you know that I mostly play flying games. Otherwise, if you do like that genre also, this is a page you could enjoy following. Tomorrow morning I'll be back to the usual War Thunder. And whoever wants to be there will be my pleasure. In the meantime, ci vediamo domani. Bye bye. See you soon.